This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. Each character in this tale is going to be represented by a different instrument of the orchestra. Peter, by the strings. The bird will be played by the flute, like this. Here's the duck, played by the oboe. The cat, by the clarinet. Bassoon will represent grandfather. The blast of the hunter's shotguns, played by the kettle drums. The wolf, by the French horns. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow.
"It's a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do?"
But Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like Peter aren't afraid of wolves. On a branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend.
"All is quiet, all is quiet,"
chirped the bird gaily. Yes, all is quiet. Just then, a duck came waddling round. She was glad that Peter hadn't closed the gate. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. It was a cat crawling through the grass. The cat thought,
"The bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him."
Stealthily, she crept towards him on her velvet paws.
"Look out!" shouted Peter. Angrily at the cat. A big, grey wolf came out of the forest. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, nearer, catching up with her. And then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. And the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. Peter said to the bird,
"Fly down and circle round the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you."
Thank you.
The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him from this side and that. How that bird teased the wolf.
How that wolf wanted to catch him.
Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, and down, and down.
Caught the wolf by the tail, and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. But Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. Just then, the hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. But Peter, sitting in the tree, said, "Don't shoot! Birdie and I have already caught the wolf. Now help us take him to the zoo." And if one would listen very carefully, he could hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because the wolf, in his hurry, had swallowed her alive.